continuing Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Part 2, Chapter 21. We had done this chapter. This chapter is called Explanation of the Vedic Path. And we had completed till verse 24. So today we are going to do verse 25. But as a recap, I will just do the last line of the previous verse. He says, these people, we were talking about people, those who have got caught up in the material world because of personal sense gratification, these people, their minds are thus absorbed in that which defeats their actual self-interest. So all these people in this world who are caught up in their personal sense gratification are lost because they do not understand the self-interest. They do not realize what is right for themselves. So we are going to continue with the verse 25. Explanation of the Vedic path. Verse 25. Those ignorant of their real self-interest are wandering on the path of material existence, gradually heading towards darkness. Why would the Vedas further encourage them in sense gratification if they, although foolish, submissively pay heed to Vedic injunctions? So, I repeat the verse. Those ignorant of their real self-interest are wandering on the path of material existence, gradually heading towards darkness. Why would the Vedas further encourage them in sense gratification if they, although foolish, submissively pay heed to Vedic injunctions? Now the Vedas are basically telling you two things. One is, please do not do this. That is number one. Don't do something. Whatever. There are certain rules and regulations which you are not supposed to do. Some things in life which you cannot do. Then, the second part is telling you to do things which are good. So some things which are good for you is what you got to do. Now these foolish people, those who are caught up in the material world, what happens to them? They have become foolish. They read the scriptures and then they decide for themselves that this is what I got to do, and they will do those things. Now let us take an example. Some person says, by looking at the charts, Shani ka saade saati chal raha hai. That means there is a Shani Dev. Shani means Saturn. When the planet Saturn is there, so if the planet Saturn is there, the saade saati, the 7 years of, more than 7 years of this planet which is there in your charts is going to affect you. So please go and offer oil and seeds and various other things to Shani Maharaj. This is written over there. And people actually keep on doing this on a very, very regular basis. If I have to ask you a commonsensical question, if the affliction is going to be there for 7 years, suppose, it's already written, it's going to be there for 7 years. By doing all these kinds of things, do you think the 7 years gets minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, blast off? Common sense will tell you the 7 years are going to be 7 years only. Right? And if it is going to be problematic, it's going to be problematic. Problematic doesn't mean problematic actually. It simply translates into, think about it, you know, I just raise this slightly. Think about it this way. You have to go through torture in your life. Torture, you understand torture in your life. 5 years of college. How many of you want to finish it off in 1 year's time? I think everybody will want to finish it off in 1 year's time. I would rather, you know, I don't want to go to class for 5 years. But the university demands that you attend classes for 5 years. And don't you think going to the class every single day and putting attendance over there? You know, in the first year itself you have got bored with it. So you have to do second year, then third year, then fourth year, and then fifth year. And you always wonder, why does it take 5 years for me to become a graduate? You don't understand. And you read in the papers, there are some people in this world, and when they are 14 years old, they have become postgraduates and graduates also, and you really wonder, pagal hai ye? At 14 he has become a graduate and postgraduate, and you really wonder, you know, this is not correct. This is absolutely nonsense. So why is that person become like that? 7 years of Sadesati, okay, is going to be there, sir. You please accept it. We have a difficulty of accepting things in our world. We don't want to accept. We always feel, you know, that that is too much for me. I cannot do it. But you have to. So now, did you understand when they say that you have to do certain things for a certain purpose? There is going to be a certain purpose. That means, suppose you have to write entrance examination, you better go and write, go study the entrance examination. Now, if you want to enter Harvard, Cambridge or some such thing, there is going to be some kind of an entrance test, there is going to be some kind of a qualification, there is going to be... Otherwise, you will never enter that place. Correct? Unless and until your father is the boss of Cambridge, then yes, then you don't have... Then you can easily... Chalo, aa jao. Or your father is so rich, that, you know, father nahi bolna chahiye, mother bhi bolna chahiye. Father and mother are so rich that they can buy a seat for you. Okay. So this is what it is all about. So coming back to this, so there are certain things in this world which are meant to be. Meant to be. So why go in that direction and scratch your head so much about it? Just let it be. It does not matter. It really does not matter. So, the Vedas, why would they want to encourage you into going in some khadda deeper and deeper and deeper? So, say, na, do this puja, do that thing, do that thing, do that thing. So many do's and don'ts are there. And you keep on doing them. And it is going to be painful for you further and further. You know something? I will give you an example. Now you have joined a yoga school. It's a comedy subject actually. To join a yoga school, I have already explained how big a comedy it is. So you have joined a yoga school. Guruji. And then you are putting the legs up and your head down and this and that and so many asanas you are doing. After doing 1 year, then the person says, you know, you should get a degree. Oh, you have to get a degree in asanas. I didn't know that. After that, you have to become a postgraduate in that. And after that, you have to take a certificate which says you are a teacher of asanas. Teacher of asanas? I mean, unless and until you want it as a professional qualification because you want to teach some people, and you want to put up that big certificate somewhere, I think that is the foolish thing to do. You are going to the gym to get healthy. If you are going to the gym to become a gym teacher, then that's a different story altogether. Isn't it? Then you take all the certificates possible in the world. You can even join the Jackie Chan gym also. Okay, does not matter. They will teach you ha ha, hoo hoo, all that kind of stuff. But think about it from this point of view. Why would you want to get all those qualifications? That means after one torture to another torture to another torture to another torture, finally so many tortures in life and you get one certificate. Okay, 7 years are now gone. All your Shani Sadesati is gone.
And please, by the time you have finished your Chandika Sarasati, you have already paid the temple, you have paid the priest, you have paid everybody so much that you have become Kangal. Kangal means you have become completely zero. No money in the bank. And no money in the bank means you start at 7 years from that day onwards. Now you start your journey all over again. But let us say if you are not foolish enough and you say this 7 year torture is something I have to go through, what can I do? But let my money get accumulated for 7 years. Okay, I don't want to go anywhere, I don't want to do anything, I will just keep the money in the bank and I will be happy. Maybe after 7 years I will get a windfall, something, you know, I will get $1 million after that. And frankly speaking, at the end of 7 years, you have made your money double. It's grown. Instead of giving it to some place, you have actually increased it. So think, this is how the Vedas are actually telling you not to get trapped in this. They are not telling you to get involved in the same thing again and again and again. Now, I have given you one example. This example is very rightly understood by those people who understand gambling. You know gambling what it is? You know, a gambler goes to a gambling den, Las Vegas or, you know, wherever it is. Hong Kong ke baju mein hai, wo sab. Now, let us say he is gone over there. He has lost money. Then he loses money. Then he loses money. Then he loses. You know what does he think? The next game, I will win everything. So he goes and borrows more, plays the next game. The next game, I will win everything. Then he goes and borrows more. Then he again comes back and says, the next game, I will win everything. Do you really think it is going to happen that way? No. If it is not going to happen, then why is he playing? First, extricate yourself out of that place. Anyway, that's a place you are going to lose. A gambling den is a place where a person loses any which way. If you don't know, I mean, something is, all the screws are loose in your brain. Understand this. You know the biggest story in our Indian pantheon, you know which is the one? Do you know which is the greatest story? Mahabharata. And Mahabharata, that guy gambles. Our main, you know, protagonist, he gambles. What does he do? He loses. Then he gambles again. Loses. Then he gambles again. Loses. Every time he gambles, he loses only. So, who is telling you you are going to win? No way. You are not going to win. So, by getting into something which is very detrimental to you, it's anyway you are going to be a loser. Why are you getting again and again and again and again into the same subject? So you need to stop it. Once and for all, stop it. But man doesn't understand. He wants to play again so that he thinks, maybe I will win. Doesn't happen. So, these people who have forgotten their self-interest. They have forgotten exactly why they are there. Their self-interest happens by means of, he has to be very, very careful the way he has to go about, right? Person with perverted intelligence do not understand the actual purpose of Vedic knowledge and instead propagate as the highest Vedic truth the flowery statements of the Vedas that promise material rewards. Those in actual knowledge of the Vedas never speak in that way. Person, there are lots of people in this world who have perverted intelligence, do not understand this actual purpose of the Vedic knowledge, and instead propagate as the highest Vedic truth the flowery statements of the Vedas that promise material rewards. Those in actual knowledge of the Vedas never speak in that way. Those who actually have the real knowledge of the Vedas, Vedas are not the way it is made out to be. people have an understanding, you know, everybody, 99.99999 go to the 100th power of 9999. They feel the Vedas are saying, do this prayer, you will get this. Do that prayer, you will get that. Do this thing, you will get this thing. Do that thing, you will get that thing. I mean, come on. If that was the case, everybody would be rich, no? Everybody would be happy. But nobody is rich, nobody is happy. And those who are rich have never heard of the Vedas. Correct? Do you think Mr. Warren Buffet has heard of Vedas? Sam Walton heard of Vedas? He would rather, what is Vedas, I don't know. Is it something that I can sell in my shop or what? Sam Walton would have asked this. Maybe I can make more profit out of it. And Warren Buffet? Vedas? You mean Vedanta? Yes, of course. I have got investment in Vedanta. Do you know Vedanta is one of the biggest companies in the world? Yeah, he will say, yes, I have investments in Vedanta. Yes, he has investments in a company called Vedanta. But he is not interested in Vedas. Okay, Jack Ma. He has heard of Alibaba 40 Chor. You know, Alibaba and 40 Thieves. He has heard of that. But you ask him whether he has heard of the Vedas, and he say, Vedas? You know, they must be there on my website somewhere for sale. Oh, you mean the books that are being printed? Of course, we can sell them. How many copies do you want? 1 million? I can get them for you. This is how Jack Ma will talk to you. Think about it. In India, a company like Tata's, that person is least bothered about any Veda in this world. He is more bothered about that he can't sell Nano. Okay? He is bothered that his JLR is today running red. So he has to make more profits in that, and he would rather spend money over there instead of some Vedas somewhere. Correct? So think of all the 100 top people in this world who have made money. They don't even bother about the Vedas. Okay? So why would anybody bother? So Vedas do not give riches. Okay? Second, happiness. The happiest person in the world is supposed to be a monk who is staying in the Himalayas. If you have not heard of the happiest monk in the world, happiest person in the world, please Google it and it will give you a name of a monk. He is a Buddhist monk. Who is he? A Buddhist monk who is an atheist. You understand atheism, no? He doesn't believe in any god. In his world, Buddha. I want to become Buddha. That's it. Think about it. So you want to be the happiest person in the world? No Vedas are helping that person. Okay? If you go to Denmark, Sweden and all those places, you see all rich people, they are staying in their nice villas, chateaus, you know, all those beautiful stuff. And they have never heard of any Vedas in this world. Okay? But you go to the Jhopadpatti of India and they will say, Krishna, Ram, sab malum hai, Allah malum hai, Ram malum hai, Krishna malum hai, Sai Baba malum hai, mein Sai Baba temple jata hai. Bola, achha, Sai Baba temple, kidhar hai? Sayan mein hai. Bola, Dharavi se Sayan bahut nazdik hai. What kind of a nonsense is that? All these people will go to all the Baba temples and all the Chacha temples and all the Balajis of this world and pray to gods. Why? Because they have all the false knowledge in the world. This is what Krishna is talking. Please understand, I am not saying something. This is not Suresh Rao or somebody in this world talking to you. I am reading texts which were written thousands of years ago. And in that text, he is mentioning this very, very clearly. I hope you understand this. This is not some BS. BS bolega to bullshit. Lekin humko bhi BS bolte the kyunki kya hai Bhaskar Suresh name. My father's birthday today. Person with perverted intelligence do not understand the actual purpose of Vedic knowledge. They will always tell you, ek kaam karna. Limbu. You take one limbu, take mirchi, put it in their door. Why? Buri nazar wale tera muh kala. Sir, my face is already black. Vaise bhi meri buri nazar hi hogi na.
I was sure you know, you understand a little bit of Hindi.
So in that, what does it say? By hanging some lemon and some chilies outside, it's not going to change anything. So Vedic knowledge is exactly like that. It is all kinds of wrong interpretation. Please do not go to a person who does wrong interpretation. 99.9999 to the power of n people all do wrong interpretations of the Vedas. They will tell you, do this, you will get this, do that, you will get that. You know, they will always keep on telling you nonsensical stuff. And we keep on listening to all that. And we keep on doing the same thing. Right? It doesn't work. It doesn't work at all. All that is fake. So I hope you have understood this much. Don't run after this. Then, the actual knowledge. Those who have the actual knowledge will not speak in this way. They won't, they don't even give a damn about it. First and foremost, if you ask them, do you know the Vedas? I'm sorry, I don't know. Actually, if you come to me and if you ask me, now, have you read the Vedas? I look at you as if I have. What is that? And then next thing I will tell you is, Google it. Maybe Google knows better than me. Why? Because I have not heard of the Vedas. Maybe you have heard of the Vedas. You can tell me. Your knowledge is far greater than mine. Because you know you have done all your puja, paath, this, that, everything. Some people have byhearted all the suktas and everything. Okay, I don't even know the suktas what it is. I know only one sukta. You know what that is? The dried fish is called sukta in Bombay. Okay, and I love dried fish. No suktas for me, that is okay. In Goa, it is called sukat. Alright, so there is no point in doing these Vedas and Shastras and trying to get all the wrong interpretation. Please don't do it. Here, this verse, verse number 26 from chapter 21, Krishna says very clearly, everybody's interpretation is wrong. With the true knowledge, only the sages have true knowledge and they never speak in this way. They don't speak. Those who are full of lust, avarice and greed mistake mere flowers to be an actual fruit of life. Bewildered by the glare of fire and suffocated by its smoke, they cannot recognize their own true identity. Now, those who have lost themselves in the sense gratification. We were always doing sense gratification. So coming back to the subject. Those who are lost in lust, greed, all the avarices, you know, anger, whatever. All these people, they mistake mere flowers. That means what? What do these people do? Those who are in the world for lust and greed and all the other negative traits, what do they do? They go and listen to this nonsense. Politicians, you know, how many prayers do they do? They go to different temples, they will do so many charavas, they will go and do something over there and go and do something over there. Funniest part is, every person who is in all the top positions, they will be seen with all the babas of this world. Isn't it? Namaste. Including cricketers. You will find cricketers like Sachin Tendulkar and everybody going to some Baba or the other. Namaste. So these kind of people who are interested, now Sachin Tendulkar is interested in century and making the highest of the runs, so he will definitely go to a Baba. Okay. People like all these politicians, they will also go to Babas, isn't it? How many politicians in the past have you seen with all the Babas of this world? Because they think that is the way to success. Their thing it says, to become successful you have to go there. And to become successful, you have to do this puja, that puja, that puja. You know, I have seen in some places where people do Tula Bharana. You know, Tula Bharana means what? Tula means, you know, they sit in one place. Imagine they are such fat asses. They will sit on one side, on the other side they will put some rice and this thing and that thing. Yeah. Thinking that God will be happy if I give them so many kilos of something. There must be 150 kilos in weight and 150 kilos of rice they will give, and God will be happy with them. So they will get them elected, they will get them selected, they will get them 100 runs, all those kind of things they think of. Or some idiots will walk from one end of the world to the other end of the world starting at 4 o'clock in the morning. Okay. With their daughter-in-laws and wives and sons and all the people, and visit from one end to the other end thinking that that is what will make them superstars. This is the stupidest and the foolishest thing in the world. They should read this verse. Those who are full of lust, avarice, greed, mistake mere flowers to be actual fruits of life. They think that is called the fruit of life, so we have to go over there and do these kind of things. Bewildered by the glare of fire. They are bewildered. They see everybody going to that place. They see everybody flocking over there. And they think going to places like these and doing all kinds of puja, paath and all that. You know, just now, just recently, now Ganesh Chaturthi got over. Okay. How many film personalities visited Lal Bagh Sah Raja? Google it and you will come to know. From Aishwarya Rai Bachchan to all the people in the world visited that place. For what? Lal Bagh Sah Raja means that Ganesha, who is there in a place called Lal Bagh in Mumbai, will grant them something. Maybe she will become Miss Universe once again or Miss World once again. You don't know that. Mrs. World. Maybe. I don't know that. So think about it. If that is the reason for going over there, isn't it foolish? Have you heard of Sai Baba visiting any temple? No. Have you heard of Ramana Maharishi visiting any other temple? No. Ramakrishna Paramahansa visited only that Kali temple because he was staying over there. Otherwise? No. He visited that Tantaniya Kali and all those places. That is a different story. For he went over there not for himself. He went over there to give a green coconut to that ma over there so that, you know, Keshav Chandra Sen will get okay. That is the only reason. He never went for himself. But he had all the, you know, throat cancer and all that. He never bothered about it. So if you look at all the great Babas and the real true ones, they never bothered their head about going anywhere. But you should not do anything reverse of that. This is what he is saying. Bewildered by the glare of the fire and suffocated by its smoke, they cannot recognize their own true identity. These people have completely lost their marbles and they have gone and doing all kinds of Vedic stuff, Vedic, Path, Puran, everything. They keep on following. And then what happens to them? They get trapped in that. My dear Uddhava, persons dedicated to sense gratification obtained through honoring the Vedic rituals cannot understand that I am situated in everyone's heart and that the entire universe is not different from me and emanates from me. Indeed, they are just like persons whose eyes are covered by fog. It's a beautiful verse which tells you, he's telling Uddhava, Krishna is telling Uddhava. Krishna is telling Uddhava, persons who are dedicated to sense gratification, those who are interested in making their movies hit, those who want children, those who want happy married life, those who want money, those who want power, those who want everything in this world, everything that these people care for, I want this, I want that, I want this, I want that, I want this. These kind of people, they, what do? They honor these Vedic rituals. We keep on honoring the rituals. Then we say, somebody has told me if I do this, I will get something. So, You can go to any of the Tirunamalais and every other place in this world and put all as many battis over there, or as many, I don't know what all. Maybe put so many nariyals, brand your head over there, and you know all the steps from down to up of Tirupati, Tirumala, Tirupati, you can light up, you can put chandanam over there, you can do rolling up the steps, all these things. Or you can do so many pujas, parts, you go to this Sringeri, you know, temple over there. My God, you should see everybody how much money they spend over there to do the puja to the Ma Saraswati over there. Saraswati is there. So they will say puja for this, puja for that, puja for this, puja for that. You go to all the Baba temples and they will say, you should write in the book, you know 1 lakh times Sai Baba's name. You will get passing marks, very good marks in your examination. As if Baba is interested in your examination. Just think about it. Baba will say, ये आदमी अगर इंजीनियर बन जाएगा तो कितना अच्छा रहेगा मेरे लिए. Can you think of this kind of stupidity? So I will make him an engineer, first class, first engineer. Huh? Is Baba interested in you becoming an engineer? What kind of a idiot you are? You think Baba is interested in you getting a child so that you can go further into some ditch? So people go to all these temples and all these people in this world thinking that, oh, my business is not doing well, can you please help me? Use your brains. You think that divine is interested in making you further go into the ditch or what? You want money, you want power, you want marriage, children, education, all this kind of nonsense, no? Don't go to people who are real in life, you know, the true devotees of Krishna. Don't go to them asking them for some stupid stuff. You know, that stupid stuff is, can you get me a good job? Why would somebody be interested in giving you a good job? Because a good job is going to take you away from him. Isn't it? Why would somebody say, get me a lot of money, give me good loans, get me good money, do this for me, do that for me? Because the more you do that, the more further you are going into the ditch. Ditch, you understand? Of this gutter of this world. So these kind of true spiritual beings are not bothered. In the last line, have they not said that they do not bother their head about it? Those in actual knowledge of the Vedas never speak in that way. They don't even speak. So when people come to me and ask me about all kinds of stupid stuff, you know, I just have to look at them. If they are on video call with me, I just have to look at them and say, yeah, I understand. I mean, I just nod my head. Beyond that, I can't give them anything. I will not want to give. Because if I give them, I am putting them further into a ditch. Why will I want to give somebody some great knowledge or some great money or some great, blessing? I bless you, my son. Tomorrow you will get married. You think I am lost all my screws that I am going to give you all this kind of stuff? Nonsense. This is not what I will give you. A true spiritual teacher is not going to grant anything like this, because it gives you, puts you further into a ditch. Think about Ramakrishna Paramahansa. People came to him with all kinds of nonsense. I want to become Chief Justice. Okay. What will Ramakrishna? He is himself not having no money in his pocket, and he is no having no clothes or anything, and he is going to say, very good, very good. Aja. Aja, you think he is some Amitabh Bachchan of that Sarkar or what? Godfather? He is not going to grant you anything. This is the foolishness that a person has. Somebody will come to me with money. I am shortage of money. What can I do? You think I have got one tijori ka chabi over here that I will open and give you? No. On the contrary, he is going to put you in further ditch. So on the contrary, I would rather sit over there and not do anything. You know, you want to get something, you should understand there is one word which has come in three verses over here. You know what is the verse? He says, self-interest, self-interest, self-interest. And Krishna over here is telling you something. Listen to the words. Listen to the words. You know what it is talking about? I am inside of you. I, Krishna, is inside of you. Why are you going begging from people? Why are you thinking that some idiot somewhere is going to grant you something? See this verse. You know, the reason why I said, you know, you should listen to this verse carefully is, my dear Uddhava, persons dedicated to sense gratification obtained through honoring the Vedic rituals cannot understand. They cannot understand. What they cannot understand? That I am situated in everyone's heart. I am inside of you. Why are you not feeling empowered? If God is staying inside of you, what are you doing? Why are you asking bhikari type of questions? Get empowered. Your self-interest in becoming empowered yourself. Not asking some begging stuff from people. Don't go running after these kind of Babajis and Vedas and this and that. Don't do that. He says, I am there in everyone's heart, and that the entire universe is not different from me, and it emanates from me. Indeed, they are just like persons whose eyes are covered by fog. You, the one who comes to me and thinking that I am inside of you, that I am not there, you know, I am some person standing outside. You are mistaken. No, I stay inside of you. I am living inside of you. Go and ask this person who stays inside of you, sir, I am capable. See, I am capable. I can, I will, I conquer. I can, I will, I conquer. You know, these are the words which we always used to say. I can, I will, I conquer. Julius Caesar never went after some god somewhere. Bole, hey, charo, tu mere saath aana, you come and stand with me. Bahubali, come with me. No Bahubali over here. There is no Bahu and there is no Bali. Bahu, you know, na Bahu means what? Daughter-in-law. Aur uska Bali. I mean, come on, stupidity that is. You are empowered. You are empowered to do what is inside of you will take you. Because this whole universe is at your beck and call. Just go and get it, boss. Just go and grab it. Krishna lives inside of you. Do not consider some Krishna as some blue fellow standing outside. Okay? No. He is inside of you. Get self-empowered. Don't come in my satsang and tell me, you know, I feel so depressed nowadays. I don't know what I am going to do. 2 days ago, one person came to me and saying, you know, for the last 11 years, I am thinking of committing suicide. You are only thinking, how stupid. Get out of it. Get out of this kind of, you know, destructive tendencies. Every time when you tell yourself, you know, and the next day something happens. Oh my God, what am I going to do? Okay, then the next best medicine is what? Zoloft. Remember, yesterday, last time, satsang, from dementia to I don't know whatever Shia that is, there is Shia Lebouf also, okay. That is also you only. Khopdi mein kuch chalta nahi hai, alag alag diseases apne naam pe laga ke lete. So don't do that. Get empowered because Krishna lives within you. He is the one who drives you constantly. Get yourself that power. Feel nice about yourself. Every day, don't get up with depressive moods. Okay? It is like taking castor oil, you know. Don't show that face which is full of that. You know, somebody taking castor oil, you know how he's only thinking of going to the loo. Why are you having this kind of a face? Have that bright smiling face. does not matter. Your world is not crumbling. Remember, 7 years, no, they will come and go like that only. Like that. It goes, no? In your life, understand, it has always happened. Life is always going to take you through mountains and caves. And you know, the train which goes, have you seen the train? You know, it will go through some tunnel, it will go through some bridge, it will go, it will stop at some station, you can eat vada pav over there, or you can go and do whatever. I mean, enjoy the ride. And the ride is most important, but do not feel without a power. You are empowered. Huh? So keep your engine running and keep on going, go getting it, you know, get it, go get it. Go get it. Always. Don't worry. All will be well. All is well. All is well. All is well. Phunsuk Wangudu. You know, remember Phunsuk Wangudu? Three idiots. You can count yourself as the fourth one also. No problem. This is what it means. Simply keep the faith in your own self because the Lord stays within you. Got it? This is a very, very beautiful explanation which Krishna has given. So we are doing now verse 29 and 30. Those who are sworn to sense gratification cannot understand the confidential conclusion of Vedic knowledge as explained by me. Taking pleasure in violence, they cruelly slaughter innocent animals in sacrifice for their own sense gratification and thus worship demigods, forefathers and leaders among ghostly creatures. Such passion for violence, however, is never encouraged within the process of Vedic sacrifices. You know, this is a very clear knowledge for those who think, yum yum. Please don't say those words. You are not supposed to sacrifice animals for getting favors from Krishna. Please, do not sacrifice any animals. Don't go to the Vedas and say, the Vedas are saying that I should kill some animal, some bakra over there. Go buy it for 20,000 rupees and then halal. Kaatne ka, phir usko khane ka. I have never said those words, Krishna says. Krishna says, don't go and misinterpret the things. Alright? Nothing like that is ever mentioned, but you have gone and misinterpreted it and thought that okay, aaj bali ka bakra chadane ka, bali ka murgi chadane ka, murgi, like that. Come on, this is not a done thing. You don't do those kind of things. If you are sworn to sense gratification, you will never understand what I am talking to you. On a day-to-day basis, if you are only interested in your sense gratification, this confidential information which I am giving you just now also, am I not telling you something? I am telling you, don't get involved in all these kind of things. Okay? Don't. This knowledge will not enter you if you are interested in only material worldly stuff. And then after, you know, pura khatam hone ke baad, fir bhi puchta hai ki Ram ka Sita kaun hai? Understand, there are these kind of people in this world. After the whole Ramayana is over, they will ask, you know, by the way, who is Sita to Ram? It's like people will ask, you know, like Krishna ka shaadi Radha se nahi hua tha kya? Uska wife hai na? Wala kaun se book mein padha hai tumne? I mean, which book have you read that it says that Radha and Krishna were married? No, no. His wife is Rukmini. Satyabhama, all those people, all those 16,108. In that there is no name called Radha. Okay? So these people, they have no clue about it and they will keep on putting all kinds of false knowledge onto me and say that I said so. Whereas Krishna says, I have never said anything like that. Never have I ever told you to go and do those kind of rituals. Those kind of rituals, killing animals, doing this, doing that. No need. The question may arise in your mind, and yet when there is Ganesh Chaturthi, I say, go celebrate Ganesh Chaturthi. Isn't it? The question will arise. Second question will arise, when you say, all this is nonsense, why is it that I should celebrate Diwali, Dasara, this, that, go to temples and stuff like that? Simple explanation to this is, on a day-to-day basis, there are certain things which we do on a regular basis for the sake of our normal life, isn't it? Like brushing your teeth. You do that, isn't it? Why do you do that? Because your teeth should be healthy. Correct? Why do you have to get all the implements and stuff like that in this world? It's because they are important to you. That does it mean that Krishna is saying, you should not buy a Jaguar? Is he saying something like that? No, he is not saying something like that. He is not even bothered about whether you buy a Jaguar or you buy a Lexus or you buy some Lamborghini or something like that. He is least bothered about it. But then you can make a car. What is he saying? Don't run after these kind of nonsensical stuff. Okay, he is just saying that. If the Jaguar is directly coming to you on its own, it's okay. It does not matter. So in a regular celebration, in our houses we used to do all kinds of Ganesha celebration from beginning of time. Do it, but do it with the knowledge that you are not going to ask for anything. You are doing it as a celebration to that God. It's like we go for a party, for a birthday party of somebody in our life, isn't it? We go to honor that person. That's it. We are just going for a birthday party to honor that person. We are not going there to pander to that person. Correct? There are two things. We are not pandering to him, but we are honoring him. When we say happy birthday to somebody, we are not doing it to muscovy that person. You know muscovy means what? We are not doing it because of that. We are doing it because we love that person. That's it. There are some people in this world will say, you know, I don't want to know anything because I am not interested in this, I am not interested in that, sir. You are not interested, you are living in this world, no? If you are living in this world and if you are passing a temple, just doing like this and going ahead is not a problem, correct? Right? So when people, you know, when they throw money in the rivers, Ganga and all that kind of stuff, you must have seen, you know, they will go to some place and they will throw money in the river and they will say, oh, like that to the deity. You think that is foolish? Then why is it that I saw you throwing those coins in the fountain in Venice or in Rome? Why? Oh, that is done because, you know, people do it so that I can stand next to it and take a selfie. So selfie ke liye tumne paisa dala usme. So exactly like that, can you just let it be? Does not matter. So if you have to wish somebody on their birthday, it is a courtesy. It is a courtesy. We are not Adimanav, no? We are cultured people. A cultured person, Krishna is not going to say, "Arre jaane de uska birthday hai, main kya karne ka hu, mera dushman hai." Nahi, aisa nahi. He is not going to say that. On the contrary, he will wish that person also. You will not know this, but in my past, every year, I have personally sent birthday wishes to people, those who are there with me or those who are not there with me also. It is out of courtesy. It's because I have love for everybody, not because I hate anybody. So did you understand the meaning of these words? We do celebrations as a courtesy to the God, to that particular deity, divinity. I will go to Mother Mary temple, I will go to all the churches and stuff like that because I find it is very nice. I just feel nice about it, so I will do it. Not because I want to gain something from the Mary. See, I come to your temple, okay, so please do give this to me. I am not there for that kind of purpose. You are not there for any ulterior motive. You just do it for doing sake. So I hope you understood what I said. When you are supposed to do celebration of Holi and Diwali and all that, yes. You burn crackers because it is okay, nice. You're not doing it because you want to harm the environment. You know, harming the environment people are talking about nowadays. You know, the foolish people in this world do not understand that today there are wild forest fires in the United States. The amount of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide and all the dangerous gases that are created over there are spreading across the United States. There are a billion times more than the crackers that we burn in India. And yet, there are some idiots in India who will say, don't burn crackers, don't do this, don't do that. You cannot kill animals, you cannot do this, you cannot... Why? If somebody loves a pig, they can go and eat it. Who cares? A true Vedantist, a true person who Krishna's devotee is not even going to bother his head about these kind of things. I am staying in a state, you know, this state, where a state where beef is sold just like that. You know, beef. The whole of India, they don't sell beef. If you are caught with beef, they will cut you. In this state, you can sell beef and nobody says anything to you. Is this not a part of the entire Bharat Kshetra? Of course it is. Don't you think this is called Parshuram Kshetra? Yes, it is called Parshuram Kshetra. This entire land was a land of Parshuram. But here, it is allowed. Why? It's called hypocrisy. It is not religion. It's hypocrisy. So some places they have it, some places they don't. Why does it matter? Another region where beef is sold is Kerala. So the arrow of, you know, Parshuram has left from here and gone right up to Kerala too. And this is all Parshuram Kshetra and beef is also sold over here, by the way. How foolish can that be? Don't ask me. So people like me are least bothered about it. Got it? So you don't bother your head about all these Vedic injunctions and Vedas and Shastras and all. What has Krishna said? Only remember that much. Empower yourself. I stay in you. Rest of it can go and take a hike. Who cares? Somebody wants to eat beef? Meri bala se. Somebody doesn't want to eat beef? Not my problem. Somebody wants to stay somewhere? It is not my problem. Somebody doesn't want to stay somewhere? Not my problem. Somebody wants to burn crackers? I don't care. Somebody wants to burn all those trees in America? It's nature which is doing. So why do I need to bother? Today Irma is going to come, you know. Today is Sunday in India. Sunday in United States, Florida, that big, it's coming, you know, Sudarshan Chakra of Krishna is coming right up to Dham in Florida, and it's going to, so many million people are there, it's supposed to be, and everybody has gone away from there. You know, when I heard of this word Irma, I could only think of a very beautiful movie from my past. It's called Irma La Douce. Okay? Go and watch the movie. It's about a prostitute and a policeman. Irma La Douce means Irma the Sweet. The name of the girl is Irma and she is La Douce. La Douce means sweet. She's a sweet girl. And this stars Jack Lemmon. Jack Lemmon is the hero of the film. You can go and watch it. It's a beautiful movie. I had seen it when I was a kid, by the way. And I must have seen the movie, I think, 3, 4, 5 times after that. I have forgotten now what it is, but still, it was a beautiful film. It's about a man who really works very hard. It's about a girl who really works very hard. She is a prostitute. He's a policeman earning very little money. And yet, the way they work very hard is what is most important. The rest of them, forget about it. So coming back to our story, Irma is coming to Florida. It is supposed to happen. What are we to do about it? Damage is already going to be there. Hasn't it gone and does Barbados, this, that island, all those islands have been destroyed, no? What can you do about it? You can't. At this given moment in time, you can't do anything about it. Likewise, in our life, there is going to be problem during certain part of our life. Accept it. It's like Irma. It's going to come anyway. Kya karega? You can just, you know, just keep yourself away and just hope it doesn't affect me. That's it. So in life, you have to be always like this. So he says, those who are sworn to sense gratification cannot understand the confidential conclusions of Vedic knowledge as explained by me. Those who don't understand, they are foolish people. So you are not foolish. You stay with me, okay? Stay with me. Taking pleasure in violence, they cruelly slaughter innocent animals in sacrifice. For their own sense gratification, khud ko khane ka rehta hai. They all want to eat that bakara and bakri and you know everything. So they will go and cut it. And they will say, I offered it to the Lord. Lord ka naam leke khud ko khane ka hai. Okay? And the vegetarian people will make some nice thali. Usme kheer rahega, puri rahega, sabji rahega, ye rahega, wo rahega. खाने का रहते हैं खुद को बोला भगवान को दिखाया. So anyway, don't worry about all those things. What is Krishna saying? Don't bother your head so much about it, okay? Just be nice to your own self. Right? Be good to yourself. Be the best example that you can set for yourself in this world. Always do the right thing. So what do these people do? These people, they worship the demigods, forefathers and leaders among ghostly creatures. So those who perform these kind of katal sacrifices and all that, they are actually doing wrong stuff and they are praying to their demigods, forefathers, unke baap dada ko, and leaders among ghostly creatures and all the ghosts in the world. They are not praying to me, by the way. Such passion of violence, however, is never encouraged within the process of Vedic sacrifice. This is not at all encouraged. People, those who are performing this kind of actions, please note, do not perform them. The Vedic injunctions are saying, don't. Do not go and take out some wrong meaning of the Vedas and say, ye karne ke upar ye milega. So can you stay away from it? Alright? So, now the last and the final message to you. We are going to stop over here. Verse 30 we have stopped. Next time we start 31 verse. What does Krishna say? Self-empowerment is the only mantra. I am Krishna who lives inside of you. Do not think of yourself as some aira gaira natu khaira, nobody like that. You know? You are not a nobody. You are somebody. You have the God inside of you. Go get it. Go get it, tiger. Go get it. Okay? I am inside of you. I will work with you. Alright? And so don't go and beg from people or anybody in this world because they cannot help you. Help yourself. No, help is inside of you. Self-help is the best help. Go help yourself, become great and be proud of it. I will work with you. Okay? So, thank you very much and I shall see you all next week. Bye. Have a nice day.